I'll show you my fuck up. Own up on our mistake.
I fucked up way too many times.
What is up, YouTube? It's Metal Metal Anthony here. I am about to go do a field install of a generator holder for a food truck that I got asked to make here locally in town. I decided to start picking up a couple little jobs. Now that my house is getting close to getting finished. Well, on the exterior, I'm not really worried about the interior. I'll do that later. I got the generator holder loaded up on the truck. It's a pretty neat one. The people went all out, put a gate on it, all sorts of cool stuff. It took me about 6 hours, 8 hours to whip it up, something like that. We get out of here. Let me show you some of the welds on this thing. So I used flux core because it's what I had. And came out pretty good. Not perfect. Here is where we're installing the generator rack down another bumpy ass road. Here is the food trailer we're going to be welding this on. We're going to be welding it on right here in this corner. And here it is. I wanted to go ahead and test fit the generator real quick. It is a tight fit. I mean, it's touching both sides, but that's what you want with this. You don't want this thing banging around going down the road. You want to make sure this thing's in there nice and tight, and it's kind of a part of the basket. That's the whole point of these generator holders. So I was by the skin of my teeth, really. If this thing was any smaller, this thing would not work out, but fortunately it does. Then we put greasable hinges on. I left the top open so that way they had easy access to the fill. And I left the back open because, quite frankly, there's no reason to buy a whole nother sheet of expanded just to cover the back when it's going to be up against the trailer. Anyway, so let's go ahead and first thing we need to do is make like a little hitch mount down there. There's a couple of frame pieces I can tie into, luckily, so it shouldn't make it too bad. You can see how low this step is. So as long as we're higher than that, we're going to be A-okay. He does want me to come above this tail light, so that's not a problem. We're just gonna make it kind of do one of those numbers, kind of like an upside down drop hitch. Let's go ahead and get this thing out. All right. So we figured out that we need a piece that is 17 inches long on one end and 16 and a half on the other. It's at a 90 degree on one end and then an unknown angle on the other. So simply what I'm gonna do is measure for my 90 degree, 17 inches over, again for my 90 degree, the other end, 16 and a half, and I'm just gonna draw a line right in between. That's the simplest way to do it without doing a bunch of math and trying to figure out what your angle is. If you know one end is 90, it's really simple, but we just have a kind of an awkward little cross member underneath there that we're gonna tie into to make this hitch. We're gonna tie this thing into three or four different places just to make sure it's stout. And this is today's work view, in case you were wondering why I moved. Let's get cutting. Like I said, we're gonna measure 17 on one side. We're gonna measure 16 and a half on the other. It's gonna be correct. All right, it's that simple. You're working with an odd angle and you don't have an angle finder, you don't know what it is. That's the best way I found to mark it. So I'm gonna go ahead and cut this piece out, fit it, and this is gonna be the basis of the rest of what we build. Here it is. Let's test fit. It should fit like a glove. Oh, it does. Perfect. Oh, that's exactly where I wanted it. Oh, beautiful. You know, I love when something like that works out because it doesn't always. Beautiful. Right up against the back frame, right up against these two sections of tubing. That's gonna give me three tie-in points right there. Oh yeah, it almost wants to stay in there by itself. Beautiful. So what I did was just slip this over, trace the holes, and then I set it, punched it. Let's go ahead and start drawing this out. All right, now that I've got a little divot in there, like to put our tap magic in. Hey, this is where the lock is gonna go through and secure this thing down. I'm not gonna get too scientific with this. I'm gonna get it as centered as I can. This stuff's my my favorite cutting fluid, really, for anything. I use this a lot on my mag drill. You don't want those annular bits to get cut up, or ate up, I should say, using them all the time. They're very expensive. I'll put the link in my description down below. So if you guys want to buy yourself some Tap Magic, go ahead and put a couple dollars in your boy's pocket, because I'm going broke pretty quick building this house. So throw a little appreciation to your boy. Buy some Tap Magic on Amazon. Shit. Buy this jacket from Black Stallion on Amazon. This is actually my favorite jacket they make. The work gloves you see me wearing earlier. Hell, buy it all. Put a couple of pennies in your boy's pocket, huh? Now we know that this is up. I'm gonna mark everything up which way, directionally, so we don't make any mistakes. Today we are running my favorite stick welder, my SAE350. I love this thing. It's a really steady arc. Starts in fucking negative degree weather, even though I haven't plugged it in or anything. Let's put it on normal welding, but we're gonna lower our OCV. So if you know what that means, leave it down in the comments below. Because we have it on normal welding, and we're gonna be using 3/32 rod today. I'm gonna kick it up to where I think 90 is. I think that's 90 right there. And we're gonna go positive polarity. I've already got my lines hooked up right there. And let's start the old girl up. Every time. There's no computers in this trailer, I know that. So I'm not worried about unhooking the battery or anything like that. So when you're welding on a trailer, that's generally the case. But you need to check that. I've welded on some MRI trailers where I had to go through a pretty thick process to make sure I didn't fuck up the computers that were inside of it. Okay, so we still have too much arc force. So what that's gonna cause me to do is go over there and I'm gonna put it on specialty overhead welding or whatever the fuck it says. And I'm gonna turn the amperage down a little bit. It seems to be running pretty smooth, so we should be able to get away with losing about 5 amps. What you see me doing is just scraping the rod on the ground to knock off the extra flux so I get an easier restart. This is a bad position because it's so low.
I got a little hasty here. I should have gave the puddle time to warm up instead of jamming the rod in there the way I did. And here, how you just seen me remove the electrode, that's actually how you want to do it. Don't go shaking the electrode holder like you seen me do before. You really shouldn't do that because you can break a lot of the flux off the tip.
Pretty good so far. I'm gonna go ahead and weld the rest of the way around. On the inside, I need to find a way to push that aside, so I'm going to figure that out now. See what I got laying around. Found that old wet sponge. I think that should do it. That should keep that wire from burning. Welded in there. You see what happened to our sponge? I hope they're not upset I used their sponge, but better the sponge than the wires, right? You probably carry a sponge on the truck with you. That's a good idea. I never thought of it before. Now that I know it needs to be 12 and a half inches over, I just didn't consider the door opening. It happens. We all make mistakes. So I've come up with what I'm going to do as my solution. I could bevel this out, do a full pen weld, and weld the cut piece out that I've already done, and then attempt to cut another piece out from underneath there. But I think that's gonna be the more time consuming and more difficult thing to do. So what I've opted to do is go ahead and just cut the piece that I just spent all that time welding in out. That's the way it goes though. You make a mistake, you gotta correct it. I can't jig rig this and do some half-ass shit to it. It's gotta be done right. So we'll cut it out, we'll cut a new piece of material, we'll slide it in there and own up on our mistake. It happens.
So basically, I put the notch to hold the receiver too close to the door.
Had that thing pretty well welded in there. That was annoying. Let me show you what it looks like. I'll show you my fuck up.
Subscribe!
So there's the piece that we cut out right there. And then there you can see I got pretty decent. I did pretty decent on that side demo in that, but here I did not. You see where I nicked it? That's because I was underneath the trailer trying to hold it in a funky way, and well, definitely not stoked about that.
And then up here, you can see we did a pretty good job not hitting the trailer frame. We just mostly got weld hanging on there, which is fine. All right, let's remake this piece. Let's clean this up and then start again.
Phone it, record it because, well, it's a piece of shit. I don't know, the wind hit it or something and it hit stop? I don't know, whatever.
All right, so there we go. We've got it welded on.
Now we just have to figure out the mounting bracket for this. So we'll go ahead and figure out the height it needs to come up and make it mount.
There's some of the welds, not perfect. But it'll do.
Alright, so I've got that all taken care of over there. That was annoying. Fucking fix this because this is annoying too. And now I need to go ahead and cut a 5.5-inch piece for the center rise. That's what that's gonna be. It's getting to be a windy bastard. It's getting cold. So normally on something like this, I wouldn't even bother getting the old chop saw out, but I had to take it out to find other shit to chop. So it's gonna be quicker to cut with this, so that's what I'm gonna use.
Alright guys, unfortunately my battery's getting low. I'm gonna plug you guys in, I'm gonna weld this out, and I'll bring you back out when I go to mount it up just to see if this thing's gonna work out good. Alright, it's welded out. The welds turned out pretty good. We've got some flux in some spots. I need to go ahead and try to flip this thing and get it on there.
Guys, I'm Melt Metal Anthony. If you like what you saw here today, like, subscribe, share. If you didn't, well, you can go fuck yourself. I really don't care.